people ask me, how do you know you want to box? I tell them like this. I know I want to box because the sport constantly found me. I didn't find boxing.
Yeah.
I never went out to go look for boxing. That's how I know it's meant for me to do this. From the time I first started boxing over 14 years ago when I walked to my first gym, which was around 157, it was a friend of mine I was going to school with. He was training there for 2 years already. And he knew me the type of person I am. Once I get in the environment that I was going to like him. And I did. When I got there, I saw him sparring, getting his ass whooped by his trainer. I thought it was hilarious. And we see the kids hitting the speed bag. That caught my attention. So once I went over there and got on that, practicing, trying to get the rhythm and timing, I found myself going back for 2 weeks straight until I got it. And been stuck ever since. Ain't no time for faking jacks. Stop faking jacks. Brothers who fake jacks get laid on their back. I'm like about 10 pounds away. As long as I stick to the script. Weekend's usually my bag, that's when I fuck up. Especially this week with the job rough because I had my daughter, so you know, they want to do everything. Daddy, can we get everything sugar? Can we go to It Sugar? We want candy, can we get this? Can we get that? Vegetarian fed, raised cage free, no antibiotics, no added hormones, no added steroids, none of that mess. Of course they give you less and charge you more. Well, that's the price of being healthy. Chin a bang of main man P2. God damn. Polo baby grand, chin a bang of P2. Yeah. Emo, give all brand of my crew. Big brother Allen Mitchell and 6ix9ine Fridge. Big black and straw. Main man Big Wobble, Big Sally here. DJ Lil Low, Big Brother Rio. Well, man, Cody put in like 7 rounds of some tough ass sparring out in this heat too.
Uh-huh. Outside.
Non-stop. Yeah, it was
shit. Y'all did that outside?
Yeah, outside. Mm-hmm. Normally, what I try to do is try to put some road work in while it's humid like it is. It'd be good for the, you know, the weight loss, for dropping the weight.
You know who you're fighting yet?
Yes. Puerto Rican cat, his name is Luis Hernandez. He's 16-4, never been knocked out, never been stopped. I don't think he ever been knocked down, so. It's another test. It's a test for me because what everybody come to expect from me is a knockout. You know, so. But this might be one of the fights. I mean, if all goes well, eventually I could probably get him, but. You know, trying to think my way through it rather than going out there slugging with a slugger. Because he's coming to fight. He only knows one way, and that's forward. But so do I. Oh! I've been around the world like a couple times. I fought, been in some gyms, I fought in some places. I fought nationally and internationally. The DMV got some of the best fighters in the world here. In the world, period. Just off talent alone, you know what I mean? And I openly said it because I know what I see,
yeah.
You know what I mean? I know the type of work that I get from home and from the fighters here compared to everywhere else, you know, but we are on the map, but we not on the map like we should be.
Yeah.
It might come down to who can last the longest in that shootout, because that's essentially what it's going to be. Just when I know myself and how I fight, and seeing how he fight. Let you know, the Latinos, they fight with a lot of heart, a whole lot of heart, so you can't expect nothing but a dog fight when it comes to them.
So you always prepare your moves yourself?
Always.
Yeah.
I mean, when I'm alone in training camp, usually I am.
Yeah.
Otherwise, wife would be doing this for me.
Mm-hmm.
I come home and everything already be made.
Mm-hmm.
But like I said earlier, she's back at home, getting ready to deliver our second. At this moment, I'm by myself, so.
In the same bed every night, so I think she's, you know, she knows when I'm sore, she knows when I'm tired, she knows.
Every fighter can relate to it. Thank God for these smartphones.
Why is that?
And these camera phones and FaceTime, because in this boxing game, man, we spend 90% of the time alone. You see what I'm saying? It's a lonely man sport, man. As you can see now, I'm in here by myself. You know, I have nobody really to talk to unless I, you know, I reach out to people. But again, you know, it's 5:45. Most people going to happy hour.
Yeah, you ready to shut it down?
I'm ready to shut it down. And if it wasn't for this, you know, having my iPhone, having FaceTime, I'd probably never see my son, my only son at that, which is tough in itself for him to be, you know, as far away from me as he is. Being as though he's barely even two.
Where's he at?
He's in Germany.
Germany?
Yeah, he went home to Germany, yeah. You know, him and my lady.
Yeah.
Expecting our second child together, which would be a girl. So now she's pretty much on bed rest for the next month. So when I can't see him, I can't touch him, I can't even be there right now if something was to happen. Let's say the baby wanted to come early. So every chance I get on FaceTime with her, especially to see, to talk, make sure she's good.
See, my story a variation of five stories. If shit flop, when it's dropped, it's this hot. My next pit stop of a ledge, just five stories. Tragic. Shit is changing drastic. Different planes in, claiming baggage. Bitches game is gaining access. To remain in, gain your asses. Ask if any of this shit is my purpose. Standing on the stage, is it worth it? So you just to try to have a world in your verses. Then you'll be a bastard, away from being worthless.
Like this, take like a little nap. Try and get up like around 8:30, go for another like 6-7 hour run, all the night really. So at this point, like EC and shit body. That's it. Put some old fight videos up on YouTube or something. Yeah. And study. So please be patrolling by the way.